हेलो चिल्ड्रन, यू आर लिसनिंग शकीला मैम, योर साइंस टीचर। एज यू एंजॉयड साइंस इन लास्ट सेशन, आई होप यू विल डू द सेम इन दिस सेशन टू। टुडे आई विल टीच यू द चैप्टर वन ऑफ साइंस, दैट इज ह्यूमन बॉडी फूड वी ईट। एट द एंड ऑफ दिस चैप्टर यू विल बी एबल टू डिफाइन फूड एंड इट्स टाइप्स। Describe the importance of water in diet. Know about the importance of food hygiene. Children, do you know that what is the definition of food? Anything which is edible or in the form of solid, semi-solid or liquid on eating, which gives us energy and makes us healthy and strong, is known as the food. Why do we need food? Food gives us energy, and energy is the base for doing all our work. So see, food gives us energy to work and play. We need energy for learning also. It means if you will not eat the food, you will not able to learn anything. Food helps us to grow also. Definitely, when we were taken birth, the size of our body was not same as it is today. The next work of the food is that it protects us from diseases. It means if we are taking proper food, then we will not get infection by any disease. The question arises, how many times we should take the meal? Meal means food. We should take at least three main meals in a day, that is breakfast, lunch and dinner. But between two meals, we can take the small meals, that is known as the snacks. Children, we eat the food because there are certain substances present in the food that makes us healthy and strong. These substances are called the nutrients. Types of nutrients. It means the food which we eat are not having the same nutrients. It means there are the variety of nutrients in our diet. These are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. In addition to these, our body needs a lot of water and roughage too. Now we will see that what are the food groups. On the basis of what nutrients are present in a particular food, the foods can be placed into three groups. That is energy giving food, bodybuilding food and protective food. It means all the categories of food are divided into main three groups. Energy giving food includes carbohydrates and fats. Bodybuilding food include proteins and protective foods includes vitamin and minerals. Now we will study one by one to all. The first one is carbohydrates. Rice and chapati are the main part of each meal because it gives us energy. In this picture you can see that oil, sugar, potato, rice, these all are energy giving food. It means they are carbohydrates. In this picture you can see a lot of food materials are there which are the resource of carbohydrate. There are two main types of carbohydrates, sugar and starch. The food which contains the carbohydrate in the form of starch is known as the starchy food. Such as bread, cereals, pasta, rice, potatoes, beans and chestnuts are the resource of starch. And the other carbohydrate type is sugar. बनाना एंड मैंगो आर वेरी स्वीट फ्रूट्स, इट मीन्स दे आर द रिच सोर्स ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट हैविंग सुगर. नाउ वी विल सी अबाउट द फैट्स. Fats are the nutrients that keeps our body warm and provides us with energy even if we don't eat for a long time. We need carbohydrate in large quantities so that we may get sufficient energy to do our work. And fat provides more energy than carbohydrate, but our body needs fats in a very small quantity. If we eat too much fat, it gets stored in the body and can cause obesity. The next which we will study is proteins. Milk, eggs, pulses, cheese and meat are the resources of protein. Protein helps in growth and repair of the body. Do you know, children, as the bodies of children are still growing, they need more proteins in their diet than adults. If there is a lack of protein in the diet of a children, they may suffer from a disease called kwashiorkor. Since proteins help our body to grow and repair its cells and tissue, that is why the proteins are also known as the bodybuilding food. The next nutrient which we have to study are vitamins and minerals. Actually, we need vitamins and minerals in small quantities, but they are very essential for us. In this picture, you can see that a lot of sources of vitamins and minerals present here. Vitamin A, B, C, D, E and K are the main vitamins needed by us. If there is a lack of vitamin A, our eyesight becomes weak. If vitamin D is less in our diet, our bones and teeth becomes weak. Minerals are also the very important nutrients in our food. Calcium, iron, potassium, sodium and iodine are some minerals which our body needs. Lack of calcium weakens our body and teeth, and lack of iron causes anemia. So children, if we will add proper vitamins and minerals in our diet, means we will eat all the fruits and vegetables of different seasons, then we can protect our body from various diseases. Now we will study about the roughage, which is also very important component of our food. The another name of roughage is dietary fibers. You will be surprised to listen that roughage does not provide any nutrients to our body, but it is very important for us. Green leafy vegetables, fruits and grains are the very rich source of roughage. Now you will think that what is the benefit to eat the roughage, still it do not have any nutrients in our body. Actually, roughage helps in the removal of waste material from the body. It adds to the bulk of the food and helps in the movement of food through the intestine. It means the person who are adding proper roughage food in their diet, he or she will not have the problem of constipation. Actually, all the food which we take in our all the meals does not digest it completely. So the roughage or the dietary fibers helps to get rid of undigested food. Our next topic is water. If we are talking about the human body, the food we eat, then the water is very important component of the food and life. Did you notice your elders always insist you to drink a lot of water daily? But the question arises that how much water should we drink daily? The answer is at least we should drink 6 to 8 glasses of water in a day. Definitely water is very important for us because we cannot live without the water. We have always listened that we should drink a lot of water. So definitely water have some special and specific functions in our body. So let's see that what is the functions of water. Water regulate the body temperature. In summer season, our body sweat a lot. You know, sweat is also made up of water, but that is not pure. It includes the impurity of our body, which comes out in the form of sweat. The sweat helps in regulating the body temperature. Water also removes harmful toxins from the body. These toxins are not good for our health. So, it is very important to expel these impurities outside of our body. So, water helps them to remove these impurities in the form of urine and sweat. So children, I think now you could able to understand that why the water is so important for all the human beings. Now I will tell you the one more fact about the importance of water. Dear children, if we will eat all the three meals but we will not drink the water, then definitely our digestive system will not work properly. Water also helps to absorb the dissolved nutrients such as carbohydrate, proteins, fats, vitamin and minerals. So children, today you have learned about the all nutrients present in our body. So if you want to be healthy, then you should always eat the healthy food. It means the simple formula is there: eat healthy to be healthy. If we are talking about the food and its component, how can we leave the milk? You all are very familiar with the milk because with your childhood you are drinking it. You know children, milk contains almost all the nutrients that our body needs. It contains carbohydrate, it contains protein, it contains fat, it contains minerals and vitamins. That is why the milk is also known as a complete food. This is the reason that why we should all drink the milk regularly. Milk is a complete food, that's why small babies feed only on milk and do not require any other food. But as we grow up, the nutrients in milk are not sufficient for us, therefore we need to eat other food too. Now let's summarize what we have learned today. We have learned that food is made up of many nutrients such as carbohydrate, fats, proteins, minerals and vitamins. Food can be divided into three main groups: energy giving food, bodybuilding food and protective food. We also need plenty of water every day. Children, that is enough for today. In our next class, we will study that what is balanced diet and what are the methods of preservation of food and why we should avoid the wastage of food. So thank you. That's all for today.